What's up and good morning, fellow Connecting Point family. It is Friday morning, and it is the, Friday before Christmas? Well, I guess Christmas is on Friday next week, so I guess, it's still a Friday before Christmas, right? So I know that there is anticipation and excitement building as a result of the coming holiday. With it being Friday morning, it means that I have another opportunity to share in some devotional thoughts from our Following Jesus Bible reading plan out of the YouVersion Bible app. And I guess I've got a few thoughts. Sorry about that sound. Coffee's on right now. It's brewing. So in a moment, I'm going to enjoy that cup. But before that, I just wanted to have a conversation about some thoughts that I had as I read our devotions. Ezra, there were some interesting observations that I made about the way that the people got the king to suspend the work on the temple is the same way that the people of Jerusalem were able to ultimately resume the work by searching the history of the edicts of the different kings. So I thought that was interesting. Not sure that that necessarily does anything for anybody, but I just made note of it in my Bible. And then Revelation just continues to fascinate me. I know that when we started Revelation as a part of our devotional time, or as a part of our devotional plans, my prayer has been each and every day, Lord, would you just help me to better understand this book? Because I think it's a book that I don't understand very well. And so it's been a unique journey. And today was no exception with the two witnesses. And something that I noticed about them also was there is some very Christ-like things that happen with them, right? They were killed, and then they sat in state, essentially, like just not buried for 3.5 days, and then they came back to life, rose from the dead. And then after they rose from the dead, they went up into heaven in a cloud, which is very much like the ascension of Christ. And so I just thought that was interesting. Some more interesting pieces, and I look forward to continued reading. But the thing that really stuck out to me today was our psalm. And our psalm was 145, verses 1 through 7. And I'm excited to read the rest of the psalm, but I tried to remain disciplined and stay on par with what was asked of us to read today. So I want to read it and just talk about it for a second. It says, I will exalt you, my God, the King. I will praise your name forever and ever. Every day I will praise you and extol your name forever and ever. Great is the Lord and most worthy of praise. His greatness no one can fathom. One generation commends your works to another. They tell of your mighty acts. They speak of the glorious splendor of your majesty, and I will meditate on your wonderful works. They tell of the power of your awesome works, and I will proclaim your great deeds. They celebrate your abundant goodness and joyfully sing of your righteousness. And I read this morning, and it stuck out to me like a sore thumb. I think just because of what I'm seeing around, what I'm hearing around, and life in general, whether it just be people in the store, people in the news or people in the church. When we read this psalm, the thing that we read over and over again is this statement from David of how he will exalt and praise God. He will focus on the works of God, and he will tell the stories of the works of God, and he will tell the previous stories of the works of God, and he will continue to tell the current stories of the works of God, and he will always bring honor and glory to God. I don't know about you, but when I read that, all I could think about was, man, it sounds like that's really just like the focus of his words. That's really, when he speaks of God, and he speaks of the story of God and the greatness of God and the wonders of God. But then I think about us today, and I think, man, that's not our story. You see, far too many of us are more caught up in bad-mouthing our political leaders, a crooked election, response to a global pandemic, I suppose, if we were honest, this place that David finds himself in Psalms is far from the place that we find ourselves in. You see, the words that we speak are not words that glorify and magnify our God, but they are words that villainize and minimize those who are different than us, those who see things differently than us, maybe even those who are grasping for power, and we don't like that. But man, last I checked, Christ said that we have to love our enemies and pray for those who persecute us. Guys, what are we doing? That's all I could think. This picture entered my mind as I thought about the psalm for today, as well as what we read in Revelation, and all I could think of was this thing that David talks about. Like, David talks about speaking, David talks about praising, and in order for us to speak, in order for us to praise, we have to have breath. And in Revelation, well, and the breath that David breathes out is breath that brings life. And in Revelation, we see the breath of, I want to read it specifically. It says, after 3.5 days, the breath of life from God entered them, and they stood on their feet, and terror struck those who saw them. See, Scripture is full of this recognition of life that exists in breath. And that is to be our story. When we speak, when we breathe, we are to be breathing life into the world around us, not hatred or anger or frustration or confusion. Enough of that already exists in the world around us. Our purpose is to do what David did, which is to bring honor and glory to God. To tell the story of what God is doing so that others around us could hear the story and begin to recognize who God is and what he is capable of. You see, but the problem is, if we are too focused on what our governor is doing that we have a problem with, or if we're too focused on unveiling the conspiracies that exist with respect to the virus at hand. Then we're not focused on the majesty of God and the glory of God and what God is doing. And if we're not focused on what God is doing and telling what God is doing, then the world around us will also not be focused on what God is doing, and they will not be able to recognize Him. And so, I don't know, I feel like I came to this video this morning after having read my devotions, and I left my devotions with a heavy heart, and I came to this video with a heavy heart because, church, we have to do better. I know there is plenty of things that happen that frustrate us. I mean, I'm there. I hear you. But we have to do better when it comes to our opportunities to actually speak. Are we going to allow the outside circumstances around us to define the words that come out of our mouth? Are we going to choose to respond to the world around us in a way that the world says is suitable? Or are we going to choose obedience to God? Are we going to choose or use those opportunities where typically somebody would do one thing and instead we choose to magnify and glorify our Father in heaven? I just want to challenge you guys. I want to challenge me. Before you go to say anything, before you go to type anything on social media or through a text message or in an email, guys, let's make sure that the words that we are speaking are words that are bringing honor and glory to our Father in heaven. Let's make sure that even if we're talking about our worst enemy, let's make sure that we are not tearing them down. Let's make sure we're not calling them names. Let's make sure we're not speaking ill. And instead, let's use the breath that God has given us to breathe life into the world around us by telling the story of God, by recognizing what God is doing and allowing others around us to understand what God is doing. Guys, change is not going to come by criticizing the wrongdoers. Change is going to come by glorifying our Savior and helping others to do the same. And so I ask you, I challenge you, check your words. I mean, we're told that our tongue is like a fire, right? It can be dangerous. It can breathe life, or it can spew death. So I challenge you this day, choose life. Well, I hope you guys have a good Friday and an awesome weekend. And I look forward to seeing y'all on Sunday. Peace out.